A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd August, on the front page you have tourists, pilgrims told to exit Jammu and Kashmir amid security concerns. So we are seeing that Jammu and Kashmir security situation is further being strengthened, and it seems to be a development for some stern action in Jammu and Kashmir. So tourists and the Amarnath pilgrims have been directed to curtail their stay in Jammu and Kashmir. And it is said that the army, Indian army said that the Pakistani army and terrorists were planning to upscale violence and tried to target the yatra recently. Then this is Supreme Court to hear Ayodhya appeals from August 6. So mediation attempts have failed is what the Chief Justice of India has said, and the appeals on the land dispute case would be heard again from August 6. Then this is UP accident case won't be moved to Delhi. So the Supreme Court suspended its decision a day before to transfer outside UP the CBI case on the car truck collision that left Unnao rape survivor and her lawyer critically injured and killed two of her relatives. So a bench of Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi and Deepak Gupta urgently assembled late in the afternoon to hear Solicitor General Tushar Mehta submit that the immediate transfer of the accident case to Delhi would raise jurisdictional hiccups for the judicial magistrate CBI Lucknow to remand the accused and to grant permission to the CBI for custodial interrogation of the accused persons. So, Supreme Court has suspended the transfer of the case. And this is three booked in different states for triple talaq. So, affected women have invoked the new law and people have been booked, you can see. In Maharashtra, first case was registered by with Mumbra police. And this is Maldives leader stays put on boat off Tamil Nadu coast. So former Maldives vice president fled his country and was detained by Indian authorities off the Tamil Nadu coast, stayed put in the boat anchored near the harbour. India has rejected asylum plea of Mr. Adib, the former vice president of Maldives. And this is Delhi University among institutions named for eminence there. So five private institutes are among those denied the status due to absence of rankings. And here you can see there are 20 institutions recommended for grant of institutions of eminence status by UGC, University Grants Commission. Then below you have no plan yet for people who skipped NRC exercise in Assam. So, Assam government initiated the NRC exercise, and there are people who have skipped the exercise. So, there is no current scheme of things about what would be done for them. And this is UAPA bill gets Rajya Sabha approval. So, this is Unlawful Activities Prevention Amendment Bill 2019. So, this bill has been passed by Rajya Sabha to now. On page 5, you have Kant Enclave ready to be raised as last 23 families vacate houses. So this is regarding the Kant Enclave, which is in the protected forests of the Aravallis. So this is having ecological concern. So these houses are causing ecological damage to the ancient hills, which are irreversible. So that is why Supreme Court has asked for demolition of the houses. The deadline was 31st December 2018. But which was extended later, and now finally you can see after families have vacated houses, these houses would be raised. Then on page 6 you have issue notice to Assam government on NRC data disclosure, Supreme Court urged. So the Supreme Court has been urged to initiate contempt proceedings against Assam government for disclosing district wise data on the NRC being updated in the state. So, petition says that it interferes with and obstructs the administration of justice. So, providing the data of inclusion and exclusion of applicants across the 33 districts, the BJP-led state government had focused on, say, some Muslim-dominated districts to press for re-verification of documents by extending the deadline for publishing NRC. On page 9, you have census may skip caste count. So, a large number of caste names are difficult to tabulate is what the officials say. So, census 2021 is unlikely to collect caste-wise data. A similar exercise conducted in 2011 by another ministry threw up about 40 lakh caste names that were difficult to tabulate. So, this is regarding the next census, there will be no caste enumeration done. Then this is giving voice sample does not violate privacy, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court authorizes judicial magistrate to collect samples of accused. Below you have Ravish Kumar receives Raymond Magsessy Award. So senior journalist Ravish Kumar was awarded this year's Raymond Magsessy Award, which is regarded as Asian version of the Nobel Prize. So he's a journalist, he was awarded this award for harnessing journalism to give voice to the voiceless. He is NDTV senior executive editor. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Valley of Flaws. So this is regarding Kashmir issue. So it says New Delhi will have to engage with all stakeholders in finding a solution in Kashmir. So recently we are seeing how security is being prepped up in Jammu and Kashmir. And this is at a crossroads. So this is regarding India's transport sector, which needs reforms. And the Motor Vehicles Amendment Bill has been initiated. We have already seen it has been passed in Lok Sabha. So Indian Motor Vehicles Act 1988 has remained in hibernation, it is said. So there is a need for amendments, and amendments to the act which have been voted by the parliament seek to address some of these challenges. But then there are concerns raised, federalism based concerns, which have also been raised regarding the bill, because it is saying to be usurping powers which were hitherto there with the state governments. The lead article explaining the Asian rate cuts wave. So this is regarding how policymakers across Asia should ensure enough ammunition to manage a prolonged economic downturn. So if countries keep on having a rate cut, then later they would not be in a position to boost the economy through rate cuts. So they should ensure enough ammunition is what is meant by that. And this is the taproot of conservation justice. So this article says that cutting down the Forest Rights Act will only weaken the conservation regime and affect the rights of forest dwellers. So the Forest Rights Act is also proposed to be amended, which is giving more powers to the forest authorities, and it is considered a threat for the forest dwellers, usurping the rights of the forest dwellers. So this article talks against it. It says that cutting down the Forest Rights Act will only weaken the conservation regime, because Forest Rights Act talks of forest dwellers assisting in conservation of forests rather than there being a challenge. Then on Saturdays on op-ed page, you have Ground Zero coverage. So today the issue is the registry test of citizenship. So this is regarding the NRC exercise in Assam. It says the chaos surrounding the NRC exercise is yet another example of Assam's long and difficult relationship with migrants. So the whole issue is covered up here. On page 12, you have UAPA bill gets Rajya Sabha nod. So this we saw on the front page too. It has already been passed by Lok Sabha, and this bill has now been passed in Rajya Sabha too. The controversial provisions in this act are that it allows the central government, the Home Ministry, to designate an organization as a terrorist organization and empowers the government to designate individuals as terrorists on the same grounds. And also investigating officers can take prior approval of DGP and seize properties that may be connected with terrorism. Then this is Congress chief out of Jallianwala Bagh trust. So the government has passed this bill in the Lok Sabha, which does not allow Congress leader to be part of the trust, Jallianwala Bagh Memorial Trust. Then you have on page 13, Center confirms augmenting of forces. So it says that 32,000 personnel posted for Amarnath Yatra will continue to be deployed in the valley. And this is India again rejects Trump's mediation offer on Kashmir. So External Affairs Ministry has reiterated that this is a bilateral issue and no third party mediation would be entertained. On international page, you have war by other means. So this is regarding the trade war between USA and China. And you can see here the details regarding total US-China trade in 2018 shown, the amount of US exports and imports. So it has a huge trade deficit, USA, which is trying to cap, cover up. So this is there. And this is Saudi women allowed to travel independently. So this is Saudi king who has amended the guardianship policy, which allows women above the age of 21 years to travel independently abroad without any prior consent, which was required earlier. And this is regarding again the tariff war. China threatens to retaliate against Trump tariffs. So US plans to impose 10% tariff on $300 billion of Chinese imports from September 1, 2019, and China said that we would not give in an inch under pressure. And this is US formally withdraws from INF arms treaty. So this is the intermediate range nuclear forces treaty of 1987, which limits the use of medium range missiles, both conventional and nuclear. So it's a treaty between US and Russia, which has been formally terminated, and US has formally withdrawn from this Cold War era treaty. On business page here, you have elected directors in public sector boards will be appointed by board, RBI. So RBI has mandated that the elected directors of public sector banks are to be appointed by the nomination and remuneration committee of the board of the respective banks. So banking regulator has mandated fit and proper criteria as such too. Then there's sports coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasr.com. Thank you.